When I arrived in Denmark at the Fredenskirke, or Peace Church, something clicked in my quest to reach a new level of technical improvising. And this is me doing the musical equivalent of banging my head against a wall.
God created with the air, the Holy Spirit in chapter 1, verse 2, say the Holy Spirit is a ruach, it's a wind. When created the human, so the organ music is the spiritual instrument.
Is it possible to provoke fate by visiting a place from which no invitation has been sent? I got no responses from anyone I wrote to in Romania. It remains a closed book, a mystery that I hope can be unlocked by my future. It was on this trip to Bucharest that I started editing this footage. That was more than 4 years ago. It's 2024, and my mother is sick with cancer now. In Warsaw, I visited and played in the church where Frederick Chopin's heart is stored. But that's not where I played the music you hear now. I don't seem to be as creative and original when the organist is looking over my shoulder. So the music you hear was played on this humble organ in this humble church, where the young organist was very kind to let me do my thing. I came to northern Italy to explore the organs of the Antignati dynasty of organ builders, and to revisit a dream from my 2017 trip. The best moment of that trip was waking up to this scene in Domodossola. I made a promise to myself I would come back.
Falso matroneo c'è la quarta tastiera.
Fourth something inside.
Okay.
Tastiera.
The keyboard. Fourth manual, yeah.
Sì.
I might as well just admit I'm searching for God at this point. And what have I learned in this search? I've learned that when those we love are facing death, we can assume they want to be relieved of their fear. They want us to help them see that they're going to be okay when they die. What I've found is that some people's biggest fear in death is losing the chance to watch over others. What they really want is to know that everyone else is going to be okay after they're gone. We need to be reminded of the secret and unseen ways in which the dead guide us always. Their totemic creations in the form of objects, traditions, and experiences are something real and alive which lasts beyond their lifespan. These cultural deposits offer some sort of universal comfort, even if you're not a believer or if it's not from your group. It's a reminder of the hundreds or thousands of years that others like us have been looking for answers and have found some sort of resolution in the creation of mythical objects and stories. When my trip across northern Italy reaches Venice, I'm back in the scene where I found myself in May, walking in my dad's footprints. Only this time, they're full of water. It's the legendary 2019 Acqua Alta, the highest water level in 50 years. They've built a bridge to Isola San Michele, and it seems like an omen. Who would have thought that only now, my third time visiting and asking again, I'm actually admitted and allowed to record the organ here. And the music is a meditation that rolls like the waves outside.
Metaphor, this symbolical story, which goes something like this, that God was talking with one of his favorite angels and was wanting to play a game and was asking the angel that he wanted to hide from humans and was wondering where to hide so that humans won't find him. And then the angel says, you know, hide in their hearts because they will never look for you there.
It's kind of, you're left with more questions than answers, which is good, because you don't get to the end. You don't say, okay, well, I've done it. I know now what this God thing is about. It's a journey that never ends. So anyway, you're asking all the right questions.
I hope you've enjoyed joining me on this journey, and I hope that my telling of it has been velvet and revelatory, and like any good story, you've delved in it. By the end of my travels, I really needed to be with friends and have fun. And see a side of music making that wasn't so deep and lonely.
But the search for the sound continues.